All right, guys, this is the Angry Prepper. So today's video, we're going to talk about the darkest weeks ahead. So obviously, we are in some kind of a bad place. We are not in a doom and gloom place. We're in a bad place. We're going to be feeling this pain for a little bit. It's not going to be over. It's not the end of the world. It's not the end of America. But nonetheless, we're going to be in a bad place for a little bit. And it won't be constant. I don't think every day we're going to see some shit. We're probably going to see some shit maybe every week, if not every 2 weeks to a month. We're going to see something different happen and we're going to be like, holy shit, you know? But it's not going to be constant. It's not going to be every day. Though, this is not the time to be the frog in a pot or suffer from the frog in a pot syndrome. Okay? What you need to do is just take in all this information and assess it. And then see what you're going to do about it for each situation that pops up, right? You're not going to tackle them all as a whole. You're going to address each situation as it pops up. So, darkest weeks ahead. Well, guys, COVID seems to be, this round, being stable. Being stable because I think it's not as bad as they were fucking telling us from the beginning. I think it's just going to be people getting infected, people getting sick, but not a lot of people dying. Because as of so far right now, as of Tuesday, 15 people died from COVID. 15. Whereas, what was it, 6 months ago this time, we had something like a day, we had something like 200-300 people dying of COVID. So only 15 people died. Now those 15 people, I'm going to go off and say probably half of them died from legitimate, old people problems, whatever it was, heart attacks, diabetes, whatever that is. But that's my assumption on the 15 people that died. Probably half of them died from, actual old age symptoms. A new surge in COVID cases is one of the dark weeks ahead. Why? Because whether people are dying from it in droves or they're not, these politicians are hell-bent on shutting the city down again, or cities down around America again. Now, some of them are being smart about it. I hate to give de Blasio any credit, but he is shutting the city down by zones, zip codes that is, and not the entire city like he did from the beginning. So the possibility of businesses shutting down because of spikes in COVID is going to be there. It's not a possibility, it's not a might, it's going to be there. Businesses are closing down in zones that are not shut down because they just can't handle, they just don't have enough people coming to their stores as it is, and they're shutting down. So forget about a second shutdown where most of New York is shut down. A lot of those businesses are going to go out of business. And that's when the economy in New York is going to get hammered. I mean, thoroughly hammered. Hammered to a point where you're going to see massive layoffs here in the city that we haven't seen since, I think, the 70s. Okay, so that being said, that's bad. That's going to be bad for New York. It's going to be bad for a lot of cities if they do a mass shutdown again and businesses close down, because that means more people out of work, more mouths to feed, more people on the food pantry line, less food in the food pantries and soup kitchens, like I told you before in one of my past videos. There's going to be more resistance to these rules and regulations too, guys. I'm seeing it now. I mean, a lot of people like, fuck these masks, fuck these stupid regulations. I mean, the government is actually like trying to control what you do and how you do it. That's bad. Now, here's an example. A guy I worked with, his son's going to a college in Massachusetts, and they are requesting his son and all kids that are online learning to get flu shots to learn online. That's by far the stupidest thing I've ever seen. And I do not know why him and the other parents are not protesting, because you're enforcing them to get a shot to learn online. Because like if he sneezes, it's gonna go through the screen and infect everyone else. These are the regulations I'm talking about. These are the regulations that people need to be fighting against, because it's stupid. You're gonna force my kid to get a shot, a flu shot, so that they can online learn behind a screen. This is the stupidity that we're allowing these politicians and the decisions we're allowing them to make. We shouldn't be allowing them, and we should be fighting them every step of the way when it comes to shit like this. So, more civil unrest, more protest. As we see this week or this past week, people are protesting left and right. People are protesting for this new stabbing that just happened. The guy that had a knife who was chasing the cops, and he gets shot, and now people are like, well, why'd you shoot him so many times? Hell, you ask me, I would have shot him a couple more times. Because I'm trying to give you an out. I'm backing away from you. I'm trying to create distance. I'm trying to do everything possible not to fucking shoot you. And then you jump around the car and you hold a knife to my face and lunge at me. You're getting shot. Fuck him. Fuck him and fuck the people who are protesting. He's getting shot. Because it's enough already maybe they should have tickled him and he would have dropped a knife. Well, maybe they should have soothed him with soothing music and played Anya in the background, and then he would have been calm and put the knife down. These are fucking liberals and their stupid ideologies and stupid thinking. Fuck that dude. I'd have shot him too. So back to the unemployment. Unemployment is getting up there, guys. It's here in New York City, it's rising. I'm not sure what it's doing in other cities. I know it is going up in other cities, but I know here in New York, I'm hearing one or two businesses a day shut down. That's more people out of work, right? Again, back to the food lines. Now, those people are going to go to the food lines if they can't get unemployment. If the city can't back them up with SNAP or welfare, now they're going to be on the food lines. Now, the food pantries and the soup kitchens have less food. I think this year they're getting a little bit of a bump, or right now this month they're getting a bump because of Thanksgiving. But then after Thanksgiving, then what? In January, then what? Again, they're running out of food. They're giving out less food because these people are showing up. So the more unemployment we have, guys, the more hungry people we're going to have on these lines. Some people don't have a backup plan. They didn't have a bank account. They didn't put money away for these rainy days that we talk about on prepper channels. These people are going to end up online and get less food. That's going to be a problem. That's going to translate to more crime. Because people are going to do what they're going to do when they're hungry, when their kids are starving. This is an inevitability, if you will, because there are certain things that are guaranteed. And the more people you put out of work, the more people stand on the food lines, the less food each person gets, the less they can feed their family members, the more crime you're going to have, because people are going to try to figure out a way how to feed their family. So that's inevitability that we're going to see here in New York City. I can't speak for other cities or other states because I don't know. I know that North Carolina, if I'm not mistaken, Prepper Nation mentioned it, that North Carolina was talking about a food shortage down there. So, told my son, if it gets bad, he's going to have to move back up here. Or move in with his mother, and I'll help him whatever I can from up here if he doesn't want to come back up here, because he probably hates New York City too. So, that's a different story for a different day. So, the great anticipation of this election is going to be another dark few weeks, guys, because people are going to be losing their shit, people might be losing their shit over who's going to win this election. Is it going to be Biden? Is it going to be Trump? This is a pretty close election. Pretty close. Now, yes, some of you are saying Trump's going to win because look at his rallies. Yes, his rallies are packed. And then you look at Biden's rally and he has like three people waving, you know, communist flag or whatever, right? So, I was joking about that, by the way. And so, yes, Trump looks like he's going to win, but Trump is too fucking cocky for his own good. And that's when you can get the fucking rug pulled out from under you. We saw Hillary Clinton pull the same cockiness, and she lost. All I'm saying, guys, is don't get cocky. Don't assume. Just say, I hope Trump wins, or if you're a Biden fan, I hope Biden wins. That's it. They're definitely going to win, because everyone thought Hillary was going to win, and look what happened. You had a lot of crying bitches in fucking, you know, America, crying on national TV, screaming at the cameras, right? I've never seen such a crybaby election. Now we're in tougher times. We are more angrier than we were back then. We might have a bigger issue with people not liking the results. Right, guys, so this is The Angry Prepper. Thank you for watching. You can like and subscribe to this channel. You can also follow me on Instagram, Facebook, Tumblr, and Twitter. And other than that, guys, thank you for watching.